Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Why don't you stand up as we start our service this morning? I want to welcome you to today's second service. The Lord God Almighty that brought you here, He will give you hope in Jesus' name. The Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 6 and in verse 9,
it says, and let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. It says, as we therefore have opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who have the household of faith. Brethren, in the morning we spoke about hope for those that are weary. In this second service, we'll be looking at hope for the merciful. The Bible says, be thou merciful as your heavenly Father is merciful. The Bible says that blessed are the merciful, for they shall also receive mercy. And so today we just want to encourage you that please don't stop doing the good that you are doing. The Bible says in due season. Tell your neighbor in due season. In due season you shall reap if we faint not. Let us pray. Father, we thank you this morning because you are faithful. Thank you because in the first service you were here. Thank you because in the Sunday school you were here. Thank you, Father, because now as we start the second service, you'll be here. Father, glory be to your holy name. Lord, we dedicate this service unto you. And therefore, we open it in the name of God the Father. In the name of God the Father. In the name of God the Son. In the name of God the Holy Ghost. We pray that hope shall be restored unto everyone that has been good in the name of Jesus. Every good thing that you have done that you believe that God had forgotten, today the Lord will restore and repay you in the name of Jesus. I declare that in this service, your hope will rise again. I declare that in this service, every one of you that has given up, that today again you will rise again. Everyone that is in the valley, you will come onto the mountain top. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory be to your name forever. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. So please feel free, enjoy the service, and the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
To come to church this morning. Can you give a shout? Hallelujah! Can everyone live it in faith? Says, I'm no longer fear. I'm no longer a slave to fear. Can you say, I'm no longer a slave to fear? Because I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Say it like you mean it. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. You unravel me with your melody. You surround me with a song. Sing it if you know it. I've been born again. Yes, Lord. I'm no longer to
Rescue me, Lord. We and conquerors. Are we happy that hope is here with us today? Hope is here. Because in Cornerstone, we believe in Christ, which is the hope of our glory. Praise the Lord. And we know all that is happening around us. Many might be losing hope, but this morning we want to reassure you that hope is here. Especially for the merciful as well. Especially for the merciful as well. Yes, you might be trying to do right, believing and trying to act by the word of the Lord. But the situations around might be discouraging as well. The word of God also says it in 2 Corinthians 4:8. We might be troubled on every side. We might be troubled on every side. We might be perplexed. But we are not in despair. We are not to lose hope. Our pastor continues to remind us, if you lose everything, do not lose hope. And this morning we shall be praying for the merciful, especially, and ask, Lord, please release fresh grace upon everyone that it has at the verge of losing hope. Father, restore hope unto the weary amongst us. Those that might be finding it difficult to keep holding on to the word of the Lord. Those that are beginning to think, is it really worth it? Holding on to this word. That the Lord will restore hope to them. In the name of Jesus. 1 Corinthians 13, Romans 15, 13 says, now the God of hope fill you with all the joy and peace in believing, that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. But by the power of the Holy Ghost, remember we have just sung, we are filled by the power of the Holy Ghost. Those present in church, those listening at home, online, the Lord will restore hope to every one of us. By the power of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Can you lift up those hands in worship of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords? Let's just worship Him. Hallelujah. The atmosphere is about to change now because the Spirit of God is here. Hallelujah. I just want you to focus on the cross. Focus on Jesus Christ, the hope of all nations. Hallelujah. There is only one name. There is only one name with power to save. With power to save. Everybody together, there is only one name. Sing with me. There is only one name. There is only one name. There is only one name. With power to save. Oh, the power to save. One more time. There is only one name. Focus on the name of Jesus. There is only one name. Oh, there is only one name with power to save, with power to save, with power to save. Say, our God is champion. He's champion. He reigns forever. Forevermore. Come on, lift your voice. Say, our God. Forevermore.
To begin to say atmosphere shift now. Shift now, shift now, shift. Shift, atmosphere, shift. Shift. In the name of Jesus, let chains be broken. Let every chain be broken. In the name of Jesus, let chains be broken. Speak. Declare with your own mouth you have the authority of the believer. Why don't you say chains be broken? In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you. Oh, be lifted above all other gods. We lay our crown and worship. Everybody together, oh, be lifted. Oh, be lifted above all other gods. We everybody. Oh, glorious God, everybody. We praise your name. We lay our ground and worship you. Oh, be lifted. Oh, be lifted. Above all other God. We lay our cross and worship.
Hallelujah. s'arrêter, il y a transfert entre ciel et terre. Quand il descend, l'atmosphère change, il y a transfert entre ciel et terre.
Quand il descend,
oui, tout s'arrête,
il y a transfert
entre
ciel et terre.
Quand il descend,
l'atmosphère
change,
il y a transfert
entre
ciel et terre.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah in French.
Hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah in English.
Hallelujah.
Let the English and the French shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Please have your seat. The Lord bless you. Let me appreciate the choir as they go to their seats. They've done a very wonderful job. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. I want to welcome each and every one of you again this morning. This is our very first second service since we transitioned. We thank God for this morning's service. And we thank God for those that are joining us at home. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Just a few announcements for your information. We want to let you know that our services during the week remain the same. On Mondays and Tuesdays, we continue with the house fellowship. Depending on the one that you attend, it might be on Monday or Tuesday between 6 and 7:30. On Wednesday, we continue to pray online between 6 and 7 after work. And specifically, I want to invite you, I want to remind you that this coming Friday, we'll be having our night vigil. It starts at 11:30. Don't forget that it is good to invite people to church. So on Saturday, we'll be going out again by 5 p.m. to invite people for this program. I want to also remind you, if you've not had an opportunity to give your offering, please remember to give your offering before you leave. You can give by POS. You can write a check and drop it. You can send it by
email.
You can send to finance@ccm.church. And occasionally, I tell people, if your check is so big, you can contact me. I'll come to your house to pick it up. It doesn't matter what time of the day. I have security that nobody can take the check from me. The Lord bless you as you do that in Jesus' name. I also want to remind you that today, officially, the Right Now Media has been launched in our church. So all our weekly programs and even the Sunday school now will be aligned towards that. Parents, please help your children that are teenagers to download it. Download it on your phone, download it on your computer. You can use it for daily devotions. You can use it for family study. You can use it to encourage yourself. It is limitless. And so in case if you are not here, then I'm going to give you an opportunity today to send a quick email
d'envoyer un email
to info@ccm.church.
info@ccm.church.
The title of your email, the title or the subject,
le sujet de votre email,
should simply be Right Now Media.
Doit juste être Right Now Media.
And then the body of your email will simply say subscribe.
Le corps de votre message doit dire.
Once we receive that,
quand on le recevra,
you will get an invite from Right Now Media to create your own personal account.
Vous allez avoir une invitation de Right Now Media pour créer votre compte personnel.
And that account belongs to you that you can use at any time, under any circumstance, to do anything that you want on the site.
Ce compte, vous pouvez l'utiliser n'importe quand, en n'importe quelle circonstance.
So please, this is a tool that we believe will enrich your life.
C'est quelque chose que vous allez utiliser pour enrichir votre vie.
And we are believing God.
Et nous croyons Dieu.
That as we all align to the direction that the church is going.
Comme on s'enligne tous vers la direction que l'église veut prendre.
That you begin to see changes in your children.
Que vous commencerez à voir des changements dans vos enfants.
That you begin to see changes in yourself.
En vous-même.
In your marriage.
Dans votre mariage.
And everything else that you can get on that site.
Et toutes choses que vous pouvez entreprendre.
The Lord will bless you. You will be opportune to listen to the message this morning about hope for those that have been merciful.
Vous allez avoir l'opportunité d'écouter le message sur l'espoir pour ceux qui sont miséricordieux.
It's just to remind you that God does not forget your labor of love.
C'est pour vous rappeler que Dieu n'oublie pas votre labeur d'amour.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Gloire à Dieu.
Hallelujah. We'll just say a song.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain. You've got peace of mind like you've never known. When things change and you're down in the valley, don't lose faith, 'cause you're never alone.
Thank you so much. Let's bow down our heads as we pray. Our Father, we thank you.
Père, nous te remercions.
You are the merciful one.
Tu es le miséricordieux, le Dieu miséricordieux.
You are the hope for the hopeless.
Tu es celui qui donne espoir à ceux qui n'en ont plus.
You are God that bringeth something out of nothing.
Tu es celui qui fait apparaître des choses qui n'existent pas.
You are God that makes way where there are no ways.
Tu es celui qui ferait un passage là où il n'y a pas de passage.
You are powerful to reversing the irreversible.
Tu es puissant au point de renverser tout ce qui est irréversible.
And that is why you are God.
C'est pourquoi tu es Dieu.
We thank you for the privilege of coming to you.
Nous te remercions pour le privilège de venir vers toi.
And we ask today, oh Lord,
et nous demandons aujourd'hui, Seigneur,
minister on our lives.
Enseigne sur nos vies.
Minister on our souls.
Enseigne dans nos âmes.
Minister on our body.
Enseigne nos corps.
Give us a new light, oh Lord.
Donne-nous une nouvelle vie, Seigneur.
Thank you for your mercies.
Merci pour tes miséricordes.
Thank you for your faithfulness.
Merci pour ta fidélité.
Glory be to your name.
Gloire à ton nom.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
Can you shake hands with one or two people around you and say welcome?
Saluer une ou deux personnes.
Hey, be cheerful. Welcome, welcome.
Et lui souhaiter la bienvenue.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's going to be a short time. Praise the Lord.
Gloire à Dieu.
Yeah, it's going to be a short time today.
Ça va être un moment court aujourd'hui.
And I want to say I'm happy to see you.
Et j'aimerais dire que je suis content de vous voir.
And it's another time of dining in the presence of God.
C'est un autre moment de dîner dans la présence de Dieu.
So like the pastor has said, we'll be talking about hope for the merciful.
Comme le pasteur a mentionné, nous parlerons de l'espoir pour les miséricordieux.
Hope for the merciful.
Espoir pour les miséricordieux.
Now you look at it. What is hope?
Quand on le regarde, on se demande c'est quoi l'espoir?
What is hope?
C'est quoi l'espoir?
The opposite of hope is despair.
L'opposé de l'espérance est le désespoir.
Doubt.
Le doute.
You don't believe it can happen.
Tu ne crois pas que ça puisse arriver.
But hope on its own.
Mais l'espoir en lui-même.
Is something that kind of comes out of your mind.
C'est quelque chose qui vient hors de ta pensée.
It's out of your mind.
C'est, ça vient hors de ta pensée.
A confidence from you.
Une confiance en toi.
A confidence within you.
Une confiance au-dedans de toi.
And I don't want you to mix faith with hope.
Et je ne veux pas qu'on soit confiant entre la foi et l'espoir.
They look alike, but they are not the same.
Elles se ressemblent, mais c'est pas la même chose.
Faith is you having a confidence in somebody.
La foi, c'est quand vous avez confiance en quelqu'un.
Is you having a confidence in something.
C'est quand vous avez confiance en quelque chose.
For instance, you believe Jesus Christ can do something in your life.
Par exemple, vous croyez que Jésus peut faire quelque chose pour votre vie.
You believe in the personality of God.
Tu crois en la personnalité de Dieu.
That is faith.
Ça c'est la foi.
That is faith.
Ça c'est la foi.
But when you make up your mind,
mais quand tu te décides,
not because of what God can do,
pas parce que Dieu peut faire quelque chose,
out of your mind,
au-dedans de toi-même,
from within you,
à l'intérieur de toi-même,
you believe something will be well with you.
Tu crois que tout ira bien avec toi.
Is there somebody like that this morning?
Est-ce que nous avons quelqu'un comme ça ici?
And I say everything in your future, in now, things will work well for you in Jesus' name.
Et je dis à partir d'aujourd'hui pour ton avenir tout. Du mieux.
Let's open our Bible quickly.
Ouvrons nos Bibles rapidement.
To the book of Matthew.
Dans le livre de Matthieu.
Matthew chapter 5.
Matthieu 5.
Matthew chapter 5.
Matthieu 5.
I want us to read from verse 5.
Je veux que nous lisons à partir du verset 5.
From verse 5, please can you put it on the board?
Est-ce qu'on peut le projeter?
Matthew chapter 5.
Matthieu 5.
From verse 5.
À partir du verset 5.
It says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Please move to the next verse. We read to 8.
On va lire jusqu'au verset 8.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. And verse 8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Praise the Lord. You see that in life, you will see that in life.
Vous allez voir que dans la vie,
faith without hope will be nothing.
La foi sans espérance n'est rien.
Because faith is sustained in the hope that you have within you.
Parce que la foi tient sa base de l'espérance que tu as en dedans de toi.
So they are interconnected.
Donc elles sont interconnectées.
Hebrews chapter 11 from verse 1.
Hébreux 11 à partir du verset 1.
Hebrews chapter 11 from verse 1.
Hébreux 11 à partir du verset 1.
He said, faith is the substance or assurance of things hoped for.
La foi est la ferme assurance des choses dont on espère.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for.
C'est la ferme assurance des choses qu'on espère.
So even in your faith, there has to be hope.
Même dans ta foi, il doit y avoir de l'espérance.
Otherwise, there is nothing in the future.
Sinon, il n'y aura rien concernant le futur.
So that hope means something that has to be really great in your life.
Ça veut dire que cette expérience doit être quelque chose de grandiose dans ta vie.
In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13.
Dans 1 Corinthiens 13.
The Bible says there are three things that abide.
Il a dit il y a trois choses qui demeurent.
He mentioned faith.
Il a mentionné la foi.
He mentioned hope.
Il a mentionné l'espérance.
And he says charity.
Il a mentionné l'amour.
He said, though of these three, charity or love is the greatest.
Il a dit de toutes ces trois choses, l'amour est la plus grande.
But by any standard,
mais par tous les standards,
you need hope to stand.
Vous avez besoin que votre espérance tienne.
You need hope to go on in life.
Vous avez besoin de votre espérance pour avancer.
So when today we are talking about hope for the merciful.
Aujourd'hui, quand on parle de l'espoir pour les miséricordieux.
Hope for the merciful.
L'espoir pour les miséricordieux.
Then you want to think about who is merciful.
On veut se poser la question, mais qui est miséricordieux?
In your mind, it's always possible to believe that it's only God that is merciful.
Dans votre pensée, vous pouvez juste penser que c'est Dieu qui est le seul miséricordieux.
You are right.
Vous êtes juste.
Very correct.
Vous êtes correct.
But the Bible says also.
Mais la Bible nous dit aussi.
In the book of Psalm 82, verse 6.
Dans le psaume 82, verset 6.
It said, ye are gods.
Il a dit, tu es Dieu.
That means God has given you a creative mind.
Ça veut dire que Dieu t'a donné une pensée créative.
To be able to think of a way of representation.
De penser d'une certaine façon de représenter les choses.
To be able to think as representing God.
De penser comme si vous représentez Dieu.
The Bible says also in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20, it says, ye are ambassadors of Christ.
Et la Bible nous fait comprendre que nous sommes des ambassadeurs de Christ.
That means you are representing Christ, right?
Ça veut dire que tu représentes Christ.
So when you are saying God is the merciful one,
quand tu dis que Dieu est le miséricordieux,
God is not coming down on his own to come and be showing us. He uses you and me.
Dieu ne descend pas du ciel pour nous montrer qu'il est miséricordieux. Il nous utilise les uns les autres.
So he wants the mercy he can show to others to flow from you to them.
Il veut que la miséricorde qu'il a pour toi, pour que tu puisses le montrer aux autres.
So you are the representation of God's mercifulness.
Tu es la représentation de la miséricorde de Dieu.
And that's why the Bible says you are saved so as to save others.
C'est pourquoi la Bible nous fait comprendre que nous sommes sauvés pour sauver les autres.
God saved you so that you can be a channel through which others can get salvation.
Dieu t'a sauvé pour que tu sois un canal par lequel les autres seront sauvés.
So who is the merciful?
Qui est le miséricordieux?
We want to see, I want you to look at some things in the book of Psalm 18.
J'aimerais qu'on regarde à Psalm 18.
Psalm 18.
Psalm 18.
Are we there? Psalm 18, verse 25.
Psalm 18, verse 25.
Okay. Are you punching it, please? 18, verse 25.
18, verse 25.
All right. He said, with the merciful, you will show yourself merciful.
Avec les miséricordieux, tu te montreras miséricordieux.
With a blameless man, you will show yourself blameless.
Avec celui qui est sans tâche, tu te montreras comme celui qui n'a point de tâche.
In New Living Translation, it says, to the faithful, you will show yourself faithful.
Avec les fidèles, tu te montreras fidèle.
To those with integrity, you show integrity.
Avec ceux qui sont intègres, tu montreras ton intégrité.
But I want us to look at one in the book or in DRB, another version. He said, with the holy, you will show yourself holy. And with the innocent man, you will be innocent.
Avec les saints, tu te montreras saint, et avec les innocents, tu te montreras innocent.
Different versions that are telling us about the different ways the merciful can be represented.
Différentes versions qui nous montrent comment le mot miséricordieux peut être interprété.
So you can see that merciful was used in replacement with faithful.
On peut voir que le mot miséricordieux était remplacé par le mot.
It was replaced with being holy.
Avec le mot saint.
But there are so many other ways that the merciful man will be shown or known.
Il y a beaucoup d'expressions qui peuvent décrire l'homme miséricordieux.
And that is why I want you to look at yourself today.
Et c'est pourquoi j'aimerais que tu te regardes ce matin.
Are you merciful?
Et te demande, est-ce que je suis miséricordieux?
Are you open on based on the things that you have possibly done before?
Est-ce que tu espères par rapport à des choses que tu as fait auparavant?
Do you look at what you have done in the past that if you are rewarded by them, what will be your reward?
Est-ce que quand tu regardes à ce que tu as fait dans le passé, si tu devais te récompenser, comment est-ce que ta récompense?
Based on a balanced scale that you have journeyed in life.
si on se base sur une balance de ton parcours dans la vie.
To be merciful means that you have to be forgiven.
Pour être miséricordieux, ça veut dire que vous devez pardonner.
If there has to be hope for somebody who is merciful,
il doit avoir de l'espérance ou de l'espoir pour quelqu'un qui est miséricordieux.
He needs to be forgiven.
Il doit être quelqu'un qui pardonne.
What is forgiveness?
C'est quoi le pardon?
Ability to let the bygone be bygone.
L'habilité de laisser aller.
It's not like you are bringing it up again and again.
Ce n'est pas comme si tu devais le rappeler encore et encore.
You need to have a heart of forgiveness.
Tu dois pouvoir pardonner.
Wife should be able to forgive the husband.
La femme doit pardonner son mari.
Husband should be able to forgive the wife.
Le mari doit pardonner sa femme.
Your children may have done something wrong. You want to forgive them.
Tes enfants ont fait quelque chose de mal, tu dois leur pardonner.
It's not limited to your family, even outside.
Ce n'est pas seulement limité à ta famille, mais aussi à l'extérieur.
Do you know that your personality is not just who you are?
Ne sais-tu pas que ta personnalité, ce n'est pas seulement celui que tu es?
Your character is the reaction to the things that happen around you.
Ton caractère est la réaction des choses qui se passent autour de toi.
So what are your reactions to things? How do you react to something that happened to you?
Comment réagis-tu aux choses qui t'arrivent?
Are you anxious like we study in the Bible study
today? Or Sunday school? Matin à l'école du dimanche?
Is it anxiety that has overtaken you?
Est-ce que ça a pris le dessus sur toi?
You must be forgiven.
Tu dois pardonner.
You must be forgiven.
Tu dois pouvoir pardonner.
Christianity means a life of forgiveness.
La vie chrétienne veut dire avoir une vie de pardon.
If you are humble, if you are merciful, you must be humble.
Si tu es miséricordieux, tu dois être humble.
Humility has to do with your not putting all that you have acquired to be something that is running in your head.
L'humilité, ce n'est pas de mettre en avant tout ce que tu as acquis.
You might be a professor.
Tu peux être un professeur.
You might be a doctor.
Un docteur.
You might be any caliber of life. Your whatever standard is not into your head. It should be able to humble you there.
Peu importe ce que tu as accompli, tu devrais être humble.
The Bible says that a man does not consist of everything, all that he has been able to gather. No.
On comprend que l'homme n'est pas tout ce qu'il a pu accomplir.
That's the book of Luke chapter 12 verse 15. But how he is able to manage in his life with them?
Mais comment il est capable de contrôler sa vie avec tout ce qu'il a accompli?
When you are merciful, you can be corrected, corrigible.
Quand tu es miséricordieux, on peut te corriger.
Are you somebody that nobody talks? Once you have spoken, it is done.
Est-ce que tu es quelqu'un lorsque tu parles, rien ne peut plus être changé, ce qui est fait est fait.
Yet you count yourself to be merciful.
Mais tu t'appelles miséricordieux.
But you are incorrigible.
Mais on ne peut pas te corriger.
Anybody that talks and it against what you have wanted or what you have in your mind, that is an enemy.
Toute personne qui parle qui a une idée différente de la tienne est un ennemi.
You must have a heart that is teachable.
Tu dois avoir un cœur enseignable.
Because you are not a totality of yourself.
Tu n'es pas une totalité de toi-même.
You gain from everyone that is around you.
Tu viens de tout un chacun qui est autour de toi.
You gain from people who God has surrounded you with.
Tu viens des gens que Dieu t'a entouré.
Have you ever heard that your allocation we come to you where God has located you?
Avez-vous entendu que vos allocations viendront de là où Dieu vous a localisé?
Many of us, we are never stable. We are looking at outside, even where we are. Our mind is not at rest with what God has in plan for us.
Beaucoup d'entre nous ne sont pas stables. On regarde toujours aux alentours, ne se contente pas de ce que Dieu nous a donné.
If you want to succeed in life, you have to mingle with people who have succeeded, not people who have failed.
Si tu veux réussir dans la vie, tu dois t'associer à des gens qui ont réussi, non ceux qui ont échoué.
If you want to succeed in life, you work with people who can challenge you to challenge yourself.
Si tu veux réussir, tu dois marcher avec des gens qui vont te challenger pour que tu puisses te challenger toi-même.
Not people who will make you to be comfortable where you are, that you don't need any other thing. Then you are retrogressing.
Pas rester avec des gens qui vont te faire rester confortable là où tu es et tu te mets à redresser.
So if you are thinking that all that you want to be among us some kind of people because you feel they are not speaking your language or they are not like you or they don't have the same. Are you sure you have a purpose where you are going?
Si tu veux rester avec les gens qui ne parlent pas la même langue, le même langage que toi, es-tu sûr que tu veux vraiment aller
when
dans
you
le
are merciful, you are teachable.
Quand tu es miséricordieux, tu es quelqu'un d'enseignant.
When you are merciful, you understand.
Quand tu es miséricordieux, tu comprends.
When you call somebody and he cannot pick your call immediately and you are annoyed that he's avoiding you.
Quand tu appelles quelqu'un, il ne prend pas ton appel, tu comprends qu'il t'évite.
Do you know the state of that person right at that moment?
Est-ce que tu connais l'état de cette personne à ce moment-là?
Do you know the state of that person where you are?
Est-ce que tu comprends l'état de la personne où tu es?
Understanding.
La compréhension.
I want us to check that in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 14.
J'aimerais qu'on regarde au livre de 1
Corinthiens 14. 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 20.
1 Corinthiens 14.
1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 20.
Le verset 20.
Brethren, do not be children in understanding. However, in malice be babes, but in understanding be mature. Maturity in Christianity is something that is one.
La maturité dans la christianité, c'est quelque chose qui est un.
When you see a Christian child, you see the way they talk and the way they do things, you will wonder that, oh, this child is behaving like a big man.
Quand vous voyez un enfant chrétien qui est mature, la façon de parler, vous dites qu'il réagit comme
so
un homme.
So maturity
adulte.
May not be about age.
La maturité,
it's about who is in you.
La maturité n'est pas fonction d'âge, mais plutôt fonction de qui est en toi.
Your foundation.
Ta fondation.
So you need, as somebody who wants to show yourself as being merciful, to understand situations.
Si tu veux te considérer comme quelqu'un de miséricordieux, tu dois comprendre les situations.
You have to be you are having empathy.
Tu dois avoir de l'empathie.
You can sympathize with people and understand their situation.
Tu dois sympathiser avec du monde et comprendre leur situation.
You put them in their you put yourself in their shoes and see how he's feeling.
Tu te mets à leur place et essayer de comprendre ce qu'ils ressentent.
And those people who are merciful, they are grateful.
Et ceux qui sont miséricordieux sont reconnaissants.
They are grateful.
Ils sont reconnaissants.
That means they appreciate others.
Ça veut dire qu'ils apprécient les autres.
It's not that people should be appreciating them for what they have done. They also appreciate others.
Ce n'est pas qu'on les apprécie pour ce qu'ils font, mais ils apprécient aussi les autres.
So this is to say this morning that a merciful life is a challenging one too.
C'est pour dire ce matin que avoir une vie de miséricorde,
c'est un challenge.
Aussi longtemps que Dieu fait beaucoup pour nous,
we still have people who are complaining about his, about him.
On a des gens qui se plaignent quand même de lui.
As merciful as he is, we see how people are still not satisfied with God what he's doing.
Aussi miséricordieux soit-il, il y a des gens qui se plaignent quand même de lui.
So even when you are showing mercy, some people may not even understand you.
Donc quand vous montrez de la miséricorde, il y a des gens qui ne vous comprennent pas forcément.
But that should not be a discouragement.
Mais cela ne doit pas être un découragement.
That should not discourage you.
Cela ne doit pas vous décourager.
That is why the Bible says, "Be not weary of good things, of doing good things."
C'est pourquoi la Bible nous fait comprendre qu'on ne doit pas être fatigué de
be
faire de bonnes
weary
choses.
Of good doing.
On ne doit pas être fatigué de faire les bonnes choses.
To do good.
Continuons de faire du bien.
You might be misinterpreted.
On pourrait mal interpréter.
Continue doing good things.
Continuons à faire de bonnes choses.
You might be misunderstood.
On ne te comprend pas forcément.
Continue doing what is good.
Continue de faire ce qui est bien. Certaines fois, ton enfant peut te regarder comme à l'ancienne école. Quand tu les guides, ils vont peut-être penser que tu viens de l'ancienne école. Ne reste pas tranquille. Tu leur diras que mon enfant, tu comprendras plus tard.
You might not get it.
Peut-être pour l'instant, tu ne comprends pas.
But later, they will come and be calling you, ah, mommy, thank you.
Mais plus tard, ils t'appelleront et te diront, papa,
but
maman,
it was
merci.
Hard for them to bear.
Mais c'était difficile pour eux de comprendre.
I mean, when you are doing all this, there is hope for you.
Quand tu fais toutes ces choses, il y a de l'espoir.
It does not matter what reaction you are receiving from them once you know that you are pure-minded.
Peu importe la réaction que tu auras d'eux, lorsque tu sais que tu as une pensée
blessed are the merciful. Blessed are people who are given, they want to be helpful to lives. You are not waiting for people to call you. How many people have you called?
Tu n'attends pas que les gens t'appellent. Combien de personnes as-tu appelé?
You are not, people are not asking about you. How many people have you asked about?
Les gens ne demandent pas après toi. Combien de personnes as-tu demandé?
Challenge
après?
Yourself to help somebody today.
Challenge-toi à aider quelqu'un aujourd'hui.
Hope for the merciful.
L'espoir pour les miséricordieux.
There is hope for you, sir.
Il y a de l'espoir.
There is hope for you, ma.
Il y a de l'espoir.
You heard it from the book of Job, chapter 14, verse 7.
Tu as entendu cela dans le livre de Job 14.
The Bible says there is hope for the tree that is cut down.
La Bible nous a fait comprendre qu'il y a de l'espoir pour un arbre qui est
retranché. That even at the scent of water.
Même à la fin de l'eau.
The Bible says the Bible did not say at soaking water. No, at the scent. That means feeling like there is water coming. It will sprout.
Même au sens de l'eau, on entend de l'eau.
Nobody can ignore you.
Personne ne peut t'ignorer.
Because you are too big to be ignored.
Parce que tu es trop grand pour être ignoré.
Nobody will pull you down.
Personne ne va te rabaisser.
Once you have that mind of being straightforward and having that integrity of heart that God expects of you.
Quand tu as l'intégrité et la mentalité que Dieu espère que tu es.
Christ in you.
Christ en toi.
The hope of glory.
L'espoir de ma gloire.
Christ in you.
Christ en moi.
The hope of glory.
L'espoir de gloire.
I want you to just note this morning.
J'aimerais que tu notes ce matin.
You are not in a competition in life.
Tu n'es pas en compétition dans la vie.
Other lives may complement you or complementary to your life.
D'autres vies peuvent être complémentaires pour ta vie.
But they are not meant to be the state whereby you'll be comparing yourself with.
Mais elles ne sont pas au stage où tu dois avoir
compétition. Everyone has their race.
Chacun a sa course.
You will get to your destination.
Tu vas arriver à ta
destination. You will fulfill your destiny.
Tu vas.
And so this morning I want you to know.
Je veux que tu comprennes ce matin.
That God has a plan for you. He said, I know my thought towards you.
Il a dit, je connais.
They are thought of peace. Not of evil, to bring you to an expected end. God wants you to achieve even more than you are thinking for yourself. You have to believe in that God. You have to hold on to Him. Bring up your hope today.
Please,
can we rise on our feet? Rise on your feet. And you want to appreciate this God, the mighty one. The King of Kings, the I am that I am himself, the one that is able to settle everything about your life. There is hope for you. There is hope for your future. That your prayer is going to be answered. But God has a plan for you. He has his own plan that you have to key into.
Il a un plan pour lequel tu dois.
Christ said, not my will, but your will be done.
Il a dit, pas ma volonté, mais ta volonté.
That is faith.
Ça, c'est la foi.
From the hope that he has.
Par rapport à l'espérance qu'il
I want
avait.
You to bless that God this morning.
J'aimerais que tu
appreciate him and say thank you. For my family, for everyone
famille.
You have given to me.
Pour ma famille, pour tous ceux que je te confie. Remercie-le.
We begin to thank God.
Remercions Dieu.
Thank God that you are alive.
Remercions Dieu parce que nous sommes vivants.
The Bible says.
La Bible nous dit.
That once you are alive, you are better than even the dead lion.
Quand tu es en vie, tu es mieux que celui qui est mort.
Why don't you bless the name of the Lord?
Pourquoi ne pas bénir le nom de l'Éternel?
And say, God, I thank you that I'm alive.
Et remercie Dieu en disant, Seigneur, je te remercie.
I thank you, Father, because your word is alive.
Parce que ta parole est vivante.
I thank you, God, because God Himself is alive.
Parce que Dieu lui-même est vivant.
I thank you, Father, because there's hope for me.
Je te remercie parce qu'il y a de l'espérance.
Lift up your voice and bless the name of the Lord.
Lève la voix et bénis le nom de l'Éternel.
Thank Him, thank Him, thank Him.
Remercie-le, remercie-le.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
I want to quickly remind you, the Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 40.
Dans le livre de Genèse 14.
That after Joseph had shown mercy to the prisoners.
Après avoir montré miséricorde aux prisonniers.
He said, think of me when it shall be well with you.
Il a dit, souvenez-vous de moi quand tout sera bien dans vos vies.
And make mention of my name to people that matter.
Et mentionne mon nom aux gens importants.
So that my circumstances can change.
Pour que mes circonstances puissent changer.
The Bible says that the man forgot for some years.
La Bible nous fait comprendre que l'homme a oublié pour certaines années.
But there came a day.
Mais un moment arrivé.
Why don't you say my day has come?
Pourquoi ne pas dire mon jour
arrivé? The Bible says there came a day.
Mais
it did not mention his name before ordinary men.
Il n'a pas mentionné son nom devant les hommes ordinaires.
It mentioned his name in front of the one that could change the circumstances.
Il a mentionné son nom devant la personne qui pouvait changer sa vie.
Then God has not forgotten your labor of love.
Dieu n'a pas oublié ton labeur.
You will lift up your voice now. You will pray.
Élève la voix et prie.
Everyone that has forgotten me.
Toute personne qui m'a oublié.
Everyone God has sent my way that is delayed.
Tout ce que Dieu a envoyé,
I want you to begin to pray that God will hasten their steps to help you.
J'aimerais que Dieu rende leur
oh, there is a help that is coming your way, brethren.
Il y a une aide qui vient de ton
there is a blessing that God is sending your way.
Bénédiction que Dieu t'envoie.
Because God says that the thing that you have done cannot go unnoticed.
Parce que j'ai dit que les choses
lift up your voice and begin to pray. And say, my blessing will not take an extra day.
Ma bénédiction ne prendra pas
oh, my blessing will not take an extra day.
Ma bénédiction ne prendra pas un jour.
Brethren, pray that your blessing will not take an extra day.
Prie que ta bénédiction ne prend pas
un jour. That the answer to your prayer will not take an extra day.
La réponse à ta prière ne prend pas un jour.
Begin to pull down every forces of darkness that is disturbing the people that are bringing your blessing.
Que tu penses des ténèbres qui dérangent les gens.
Every stronghold against the arrival of my blessing. I pull you down in the name of Jesus.
Je te brise au nom de Jésus.
Oh, brethren, begin to pray.
Frère, commence à prier.
I say your blessing is around the corner.
Je dis que ta prédiction.
Begin to pray. The Bible says that whatever you bind on earth is loose, it is bound in heaven.
Nous fait comprendre que tout ce qu'on attache sur terre.
Why don't you pray?
Pourquoi ne pas prier?
Every one of my blessings that is bound.
Toutes mes bénédictions qui sont attachées.
I let it loose in the name of Jesus.
Lâche au nom de Jésus.
Every one of my blessings that is bound. I let you loose in the name of Jesus. Oh, brethren, begin to loose. Begin to loose right now. Begin to loose. Begin to loose. Every blessing on your right side. Every blessing on your left side. Every blessing that is in front of you. Every blessing that is running to catch up with you. I want you to pray and say, my blessing will not, my blessing I will not miss.
Je ne vais pas prier, je vais manquer.
Oh, I will not miss them in the name of Jesus.
Je ne vais pas manquer ma bénédiction.
Let them pray that men that need to remember you, that they will remember you today.
Pour que les hommes qui doivent se souvenir de toi.
Pray that people that matter, that they will remember you today.
Les gens qui sont importants se souviennent de toi.
Above all, I want you to pray that God will remember you today.
Et par-dessus tout, prie pour que Dieu se rappelle de toi.
The Bible says that God remembered Hannah.
La Bible nous fait comprendre que Dieu s'est souvenu.
Oh, brother, why don't you pray?
Pourquoi ne pas prier, frère?
That God will remember you today.
Que Dieu se souvient de toi aujourd'hui.
Whenever God remembers a man, he remembers him to do something for him.
Quand Dieu se souvient d'un homme, il se rappelle.
Lift up your voice and say, God, remember my family today.
Dis, Seigneur, rappelle-toi de ma famille.
Lift up your voice and say, God, remember my marriage today. Lift up your voice and say, God, remember my children today.
Élève la voix et dis, Seigneur, souviens-toi de mes
enfants. You are not praying like people that are desperate.
Prie comme quelqu'un.
You are not praying like people that God must remember you today.
Vous ne priez pas comme des gens que Dieu doit se souvenir.
Say, God, remember your promise to me today.
Dis, Seigneur, souviens-toi de tes promesses envers moi aujourd'hui.
Say, God, remember your promise concerning the work of my hands today.
Souviens-toi des promesses contenant le travail de mes mains.
Brethren, cry to the merciful God.
Priez au Dieu miséricordieux.
I cry to the merciful God.
Priez au Dieu miséricordieux.
The king said, if God does not help you, who else can help you?
Si Dieu ne t'aide pas, qui d'autre pourra t'aider?
Pray and say, God, help me speak to my boss.
Seigneur, aide-moi, parle à mon
God, God, help me speak to my husband.
Parle à mon époux.
God, help me speak to my wife.
Seigneur, aide-moi, parle à mon
God,
époux.
God, help me speak to my children.
Seigneur, aide-moi, parle à mes enfants.
God, help me speak to my parents.
Seigneur, aide-moi, parle à mes
parents. God, help me today, help me today.
Seigneur, aide-moi aujourd'hui.
Pray that God will help you today.
Prie pour que Dieu puisse t'aider aujourd'hui.
Brethren, don't keep quiet before God. Pray that the Lord will help you today. In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Au nom puissant de Jésus, nous avons prié.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Au nom puissant de Jésus, nous avons prié.
Brethren, the Bible says, a whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
La Bible nous fait comprendre que qui importe le nom de Jésus sera sauvé.
Either you are good or not, it doesn't guarantee you anything.
Quand que tu sois bon ou mauvais, ça ne te garantit rien.
But it is the mercy of God that makes God to forget your sins.
C'est la miséricorde de Dieu qui permet de te pardonner tes péchés.
It is the mercy of God unto salvation that has brought you where you are.
C'est la miséricorde de Dieu dans le salut.
Those of you at home and those of you here, you will lift up your voice unto God.
À la maison comme ceux ici, élevez votre voix.
And say every way that I've turned away from the path of righteousness.
Toutes les voies que j'ai pris qui m'ont éloigné de ta justice.
The Lord, I am coming back home. Accept me.
Seigneur, je reviens à la maison.
Brethren, the Bible says, if we say we have no sin, we have made him a liar.
La Bible nous fait comprendre que si nous disons qu'on a
pas de péché, but if you confess your sins, he is faithful and is just.
La Bible nous dit de confesser nos péchés, les fidèles et justes.
Lift up your voice and begin to pray.
C'est pourquoi nous devons commencer à prier.
The Bible says that God does not want the death of a sinner, but that all should come to repentance.
Il ne veut pas la mort des pécheurs, mais il voudrait que nous venions tous à la repentance.
If you are coming to God afresh, begin to pray that we will accept you.
Si tu viens de nouveau à Dieu, il va t'accepter.
If you are returning to God, begin to pray that he will accept you back.
Si tu retournes à lui, commence à prier pour qu'il t'accepte.
Lift up your voice and begin to pray.
Commence à prier.
And say, Lord, accept me back.
Et disons, Seigneur, accepte-moi.
I have gone on my own journey.
Je suis parti dans mon propre chemin.
I have tasted life. I have seen that there's no one that is as good as you.
J'ai péché, il n'y a personne qui soit bon comme toi.
Like the prodigal son.
Priez comme le fils prodigieux.
And say, just accept me, Lord, oh God, to be one of your children.
Et priez pour que Dieu puisse vous accepter comme l'un de ses enfants.
Those of you that at home pray with us.
Ceux qui sont à la maison, priez avec
that
nous.
God will accept you today.
Que Dieu puisse nous accepter aujourd'hui.
That God will accept your sacrifice for sin.
Que Dieu puisse accepter ton sacrifice.
Because Jesus has already sacrificed for it all.
Parce que Jésus s'est déjà sacrifié pour nous tous.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
Lastly, we want to pray.
Finalement, nous voulons
prier. The Bible
prier.
Tells us in the book of Esther.
Dans le livre d'Esther, la Bible nous
that
dit.
That Mordecai had done a good that had been forgotten.
Que Mordecai a fait du bien, il a été oublié.
No, the Bible says there was a day the king could not sleep.
Et la Bible nous dit qu'il y avait une nuit, le roi ne pouvait pas
and
dormir.
Decided, let us go through the book of records and see.
Il a dit, allons au travers du livre des records.
Is there anybody merciful in that book that we need to repay?
Et s'il y a quelqu'un de miséricordieux dans ce livre à qui on doit payer?
And the Bible says he found a place.
Et la Bible nous dit qu'on a trouvé une place.
They will find a place where your good deed is written.
Là où tes bienfaits sont écrits.
It looks like you don't believe it.
C'est comme si vous n'y croyez pas.
I said they will find the place where your name is written.
On va trouver un lieu où ton nom a été écrit.
And then the Bible says, they said, what have we done unto him?
La Bible nous fait comprendre qu'est-ce que nous avons fait pour lui.
They said nothing.
Et ça nous dit rien.
Unknown to the king.
Sans savoir que le roi.
The enemy were plotting the downfall of Mordecai.
Les gens, l'ennemi planifiait pour tuer le roi.
So God made his enemy to be the one to promote him.
Et Dieu a fait que les ennemis soient
ceux qui l'ont promu. Will promote you.
Ouais, tes ennemis vont te
promouvoir.
Au nom de Jésus.
I want you to pray lastly today.
Et je veux que tu pries finalement.
Everywhere my name is mentioned this week.
Partout où mon nom est mentionné en cette semaine.
Everywhere my name has been written down in the book.
Partout où mon nom a été écrit dans le livre.
Let there be an opening for remembrance.
Qui est un souvenir.
Pray.
Qui est un rappel, priez.
Let it be open for remembrance in the name of Jesus.
Qui est un rappel au nom de Jésus.
Yes, pray that the book of remembrance in your office will be open.
Que le livre des souvenirs dans ton lieu de
travail. Pray that the book of remembrance in your marriage will be open.
Que le livre des souvenirs.
Oh, pray that the book of remembrance in heaven will be open.
Que le livre des souvenirs dans les cieux soit ouvert.
That God will open the windows of heaven unto you.
Que Dieu ouvre les fenêtres des cieux pour toi.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Au nom de Jésus Christ.
Pray for 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute.
Prions pour 1 minute.
And say, God, let the heavens open the books concerning me.
Que les cieux ouvrent le livre me concernant.
The book of promotion.
Le livre de la promotion.
The book of blessings.
Le livre des bénédictions.
The books of good health.
Le livre de la bonne
oh,
santé.
The books of marital bliss.
Le livre de la
the
paix
books of children that are destined for signs and wonders.
Le livre des enfants qui sont destinés pour les signes et les prodiges.
Let my books be opened, O God.
Que mes livres soient ouverts.
Let everyone open the books over me.
Que tout livre qui soit ouvert me concerne.
Let open the books over my children.
Que les cieux ouvrent les livres
let
concernant mes enfants.
Open the books over my husband.
Que les cieux ouvrent les livres
let
concernant
open
mon
the
mari.
Books over my wife.
Que les cieux ouvrent le livre concernant ma femme.
Lift up your voice, you have 30 seconds more.
Vous avez 30 secondes de plus.
The heaven will open the books of remembrance today.
Que les cieux ouvrent le livre de souvenirs aujourd'hui.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
Glory be to your name, my God.
Que ton nom soit glorifié.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
And so, Father, we want to bless you for today.
Père, nous voulons te bénir pour aujourd'hui.
Thank you, Father, because you called us and we came.
Merci parce que tu nous as appelés et nous sommes venus.
Thank you, Father, because we know that no one sees your glory and remains the same.
Nous te remercions parce que personne ne voit ta gloire et demeure le même.
We thank you above everything else that we might have come hopeless, but we are not living hopeless.
Nous te remercions par-dessus tout ce que nous sommes venus sans espoir, mais nous ne repartons pas sans
espoir. Thank you because the weary are revived.
Merci parce que tu as eu un réveil.
Thank you, God, because the hopeless have received hope.
Parce que ceux qui n'avaient pas d'espoir ont reçu l'espérance.
Thank you, Father, because those that thought that everything that they did had gone to waste, they've known that you are not a respecter of persons.
Merci parce que tous ces gens pensaient qu'ils n'avaient tout ce qu'ils avaient fait gâché.
And so, Father, I commit your children into your hands, O God.
Mais nous te confions tes enfants aujourd'hui.
As they go today,
comme ils s'en vont aujourd'hui,
let their hope never be dashed again.
Que leur espérance ne soit plus au nom de Jésus.
I pray as they go today, oh Lord.
Je prie comme ils s'en vont aujourd'hui.
Encourage them.
Encourage-les.
I said that phone call they've been waiting for, may they receive it.
Que l'appel qu'ils espéraient.
That
qu'ils
email that they are waiting for, may they receive it.
Que l'email qu'ils espéraient.
In the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Blessings that they are not even waiting for.
Même les bénédictions qui n'attendent
pas. The Bible says that our God in heaven knows the things that we need even before we ask Him.
La Bible nous fait comprendre que Dieu connaît ce dont
and
nous
so,
avons besoin.
Father, today I join my faith with this.
Aujourd'hui, je joins ma foi
that
avec
even
eux.
The blessings that they are not waiting for.
Même les bénédictions qui n'attendent pas.
Lord, before the end of this month, may they receive it in the name of Jesus.
Seigneur, à la fin de ce mois, qu'ils puissent le recevoir.
As you go,
comme ils s'en vont,
may the power of God go with you.
Que la puissance de Dieu aille
may
avec
the presence
eux.
Of God be with you.
Que la présence de Dieu soit avec
in
eux.
The name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
May men see the glory of God over your life.
Que les hommes voient la gloire
in
de Dieu sur ta vie.
Jesus Christ.
Au nom de Jésus Christ.
The Bible says, in due season you will reap.
La Bible nous fait comprendre
que
ton
moment
de
season has come.
Je déclare que
in the name of Jesus.
Au nom de Jésus.
Your season shall not be cut short.
And
locusts will not cut your season short. Farmer worms will not cut your season short. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
Glory be to your name, my
que
God.
Que ton nom soit glorifié.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons
in
prié.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
Au nom de Jésus, nous avons prié.
If you are clapping like those that have received hope, you better clap properly.
Je vais applaudir proprement.
Let me hear you shout hallelujah. Just a couple of announcements before we share the grace.
Quelques annonces avant de partager la grâce.
If you are worshiping with us for the first time, we are very happy to see you.
Nous sommes contents de vous avoir ici si vous êtes ici.
Please fill out the cards that the ushers have given you.
Remplissez le formulaire que les ushers vous ont donné.
I will speak with you before you leave.
Et on va parler vraiment avec
for
vous.
For those of us at home and those of us that are here, I want to remind you that the series continues next week.
Pour ceux qui sont ici ou à la maison, la série continue la semaine prochaine.
Next week, we'll be talking about two other groups that hope might have been lost.
On va parler de deux autres groupes qui ont peut-être perdu espoir.
And I believe God strongly.
Et je crois fermement en Dieu.
By the time you already come next week, you have your testimony in Jesus' name.
Par le moment où tu viens la semaine prochaine, tu auras ton témoignage.
Shall we share the grace in fellowship?
Partageons la grâce.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. We shall live, we shall not die. We shall live to declare the works of God in the land of the living. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. The Lord bless you. Have a very wonderful week.